All right, well, welcome back to another episode of Tul World podcast. I'm your host, David Ju, and I'm here with Master Ju.
Nice sunny day today, Mr. Ju.
Anyways, what's been going on?
Same old, same old. Classes.
Yeah.
Getting back into some more sparring and tournaments, and those are coming back around.
Yeah.
Trying to organize it. We just generally like to stay busy.
Yeah, pretty much. Make your own work. You create your own
like
pressure
this?
On yourself. I'm like, oh, gotta get this done, gotta get this pressured. Yeah.
Like doing this podcast?
I know, this, yeah.
We just like to talk to ourselves.
Pretty much, yeah. But, you know, sometimes you have good classes. Sometimes you don't have not so good classes. Sometimes the kids are really motivated, and sometimes they're not too motivated. It's just the day. Some days, you know, you can just tell just everyone's just having a bad day. And then some days everyone's just having a good day. I don't know what it is. It's just life's going in cycles. But how do you motivate?
And then you also have students that just are not motivated all the time.
Yeah, that's true too. But how do you go about and motivating people?
Well, I would definitely say this is that there are certain things you can control. Mm-hmm. And you definitely can't control other people in a way. You can help them.
Yeah.
You can guide them along. Mm-hmm. You can, you know, encourage them. But you cannot necessarily make them do something that they don't really want to do or they want to do.
Yeah.
I'm talking about that non-motivational part. And so as an instructor, I think we shouldn't try to take it too personal. And you just do the best you can. Mm-hmm. And you walk away from it, from that. Let's say the class was awesome. You walk away and you feel good.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have classes and you go, ooh, that was rough. It's like they weren't listening or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's the way it is.
Yeah.
But don't beat yourself up on it.
Right.
Think about it and go, okay, could I have made it better?
Yeah.
I don't know. Because sometimes I definitely have had students that were not motivated no matter what. You could praise them. You could scold them. You could discipline them. You could whatever. Mm-hmm. Right. I threw everything at them. Mm-hmm. Nada. Nada.
Right.
So I just like, okay, that's the way it is. Just got to move on.
Have you found something that has changed? Like, maybe they weren't motivated before, but they flipped a switch. Was there a particular reason?
I think, yeah, no, you do definitely see that. Mm-hmm. I think sometimes when they first start, it's like, well, this is exciting, this is new. Mm-hmm. And they want to do it, the parents want them to do it. We're talking about kids, obviously.
Yeah.
When it comes to adults, I think if they're not motivated, just quit.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So when we talk about kids, I think kids are like, parents make them do it sometimes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the kids want to do it, so they're excited. There can be a time when things can get repetitive. I kind of think that when they hit around yellow belt, things get to be repetitive, and it's like, what am I doing this for? And so people do need to understand why.
Yeah.
Why do I do certain things?
Right.
And that can really help. And you can... Tournaments are great to help motivate people because they're working for that. But then not everyone's into tournaments.
Yeah.
So there has to be a reason why that switch changes for them. Whether it's that, black belt is just around the corner and I really enjoy it. Or my friends are doing it. Or I've made some new friends and so they are more into it. So I don't know if there's a specific reason why someone gets more motivated or what changes them. Mm-hmm. But if we can definitely keep them moving forward and try to encourage them, maybe that day comes. And that actually, I do remember having a student that was just not too motivated. We finally got him to test for black belt.
Yeah.
And for some reason, he just changed a little bit and became an awesome black belt.
Right.
became a second degree black belt, you know? And
yeah.
I don't know what it is specifically.
Yeah, no, you can kind of see that with some of the white belts too. You know, right when they get the yellow stripe, they're excited.
Right.
And then they start shaping up a little bit. And then right when they hit yellow belt, they either, you know, they might get really into it.
Right.
Sometimes. I've noticed that, is that they're kind of dropping off a little bit, not looking as motivated as a white belt, but when they became a yellow belt, something kind of clicked, they start gearing up.
You find that at blue belt too, I think.
I think that when you get to about any solid color, I think when they get to a whole new color, that kind of happens. That's what I think. I do kind of notice that.
Oh, solid colors, huh?
Right. Well, maybe that's why, I don't know how WT, what their color system is like, but they don't have the halves. They just go new colors each time.
Well, you know, no, that's a good point, because some schools have multiple stripes, and we have been sticking with the traditional...
One stripe?
Yeah. One stripe since the way General Che had presented in the encyclopedia.
Yeah.
But you do have schools that have multiple stripes. And so why do they do that? Well, it's more of a motivational thing. They can see achievements, and that's the ranking system is, in a way, is a way to help recognize what you've been doing and helps you keep you motivated to keep moving forward. So you might have schools that have multiple stripes just to help them. Yeah, they've learned this task or whatever it is, and helps them motivate them to a little bit next level.
Yeah.
But blue belt, like, kind of think at the higher ranks, sometimes it gets to be a little bit too hard. You have to actually put in a little bit more effort.
Right.
You've got to train a little bit more to be a little bit more proficient. They're not moving through the ranks as fast. It's just the skill sets are harder.
Right.
So I think the key to anything, regardless of Taekwondo, school, work, is we have to understand why. Why do we do these things?
Yeah.
And so you get to a higher rank, and it's like, oh my gosh, it's going to be another 3 years before I can become a next rank, or maybe it's 4 years. So if the rank was the thing that was motivating you, then ultimately it's going to just come to an end.
Right.
It's like, well, I'm a first degree black belt. What am I doing now? I mean, I'm a black belt, right?
Yeah.
Well, you could go to ninth. And then the question is, why do I want to do that?
Yeah.
So the reason has to be, you have to have a why, I think. And if you know where what your why is, then you can achieve that. So, and ranking system is great to help you reach those goals. But if your goal or if your why was to become a black belt, when you hit the black belt, where's your why? Yep. Your why is gone because you've achieved that.
Right.
But I think why should be more of a bigger picture. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's self-defense. Mm-hmm. So, well, if it's self-defense, you kind of got to always train. And it doesn't matter what rank you are.
That's true. All right, well, thanks for jumping into another Tul World podcast. Let us know your main motivation for doing martial arts. Don't forget to leave us a like on the video or the podcast and share this with all your fellow friends. And as always, don't forget to be safe.
Keep training.
And we'll see you guys next time.
Taekwon-Do.